Hey guys, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use a timeline in Adobe Premiere Pro. Let's get started. Firstly, we need to add our footage to the sequence on the timeline. Double-click on the media file you want to use. It will open in the source monitor, allowing you to select specific parts you want to use in your video. Use I to set the endpoint and O to set the outpoint for your selection. This way, you only use the best parts of your clips. After trimming your video, drag it from the source monitor and drop it onto the video track in the timeline panel. If your video has audio, it will automatically link to the video. To separate them, drag the audio part to a different audio track. Now let's discuss about the options available on the timeline. Firstly, we have source patching for inserts and overwrites. Source patching in Premiere Pro allows you to control which tracks in your timeline are affected when you add or replace a clip from the source monitor. It ensures that the selected clip goes exactly where you want it in the timeline. It's especially useful for projects with many video and audio tracks, giving you precise control over where your new clips should go. To enable source patching, click the source patching button for the desired track in the timeline or use the keyboard shortcut, comma, for video tracks and audio tracks. For overwriting clips, use the keyboard shortcut, full stop, for both video and audio tracks. This feature helps you manage your timeline effectively when dealing with multiple video and audio layers. Next, we have toggle track lock for the audio and the video layers. Each layer comes with its own toggle lock. When a layer is locked, we are unable to modify or edit it. For example, let's lock the V1 layer. Now we can't even select the clips on layer V1. Now let's discuss the timeline's video and audio layers. It's pretty straightforward. The video layers are named V1, V2, and V3, while the audio layers are named A1, A2, and A3. Then we have a toggle for track targeting, which can be toggled by clicking on the layer names, such as V1 and A1. By default, V1 and A1 are toggled on for track targeting. If you want to paste a clip on the V2 layer, make sure the V2 layer is toggled on, and then simply paste away. The same goes for audio layers. Then we have toggle sync lock, which is automatically enabled. It ensures that all tracks which are toggled on are affected equally by certain adjustments made to any track. For example, we have this clip on V3 with audio attached to the A3 track. If you toggle off the sync lock for A3 and ripple delete the clip on V2, you'll see that all tracks except A3 are affected. Now let's undo and toggle on the sync lock for A3. Now I'm ripple deleting the clip from V2. You can see the audio track A3 is also affected by ripple delete. To keep things organized, we've got an eye icon for toggle track output. If you disable it, you won't see the output of that particular layer. For example, I will toggle off layer V2. Now you can't see the output for layer V2. In audio, we have a mute icon that mutes the audio track. Besides mute, we have a solo track. All the tracks except the solo track enabled will be muted. Only the enabled audio track will be played. Then we have a microphone icon that helps us to record voiceover directly in Premiere Pro. For example, if you position the playhead at a specific point, the recording will start from that position. By clicking on the icon, Premiere Pro will start recording voiceover. Now click again to stop recording, and the recorded layer will be added to your timeline. You can always adjust the heights of the layers by simply double-clicking on that layer to expand that particular track. Or else you can hold and drag the lines between two tracks to expand them. It can be also done by pressing Alt on Windows or Option on Mac, and scrolling the mouse wheel will expand and contract the layer. Make sure this will affect the layer on which your cursor will be placed. So we'll start from the top left first. We have a sequence time code here, which portrays time from hours, minutes, seconds, and frames per second. Then, we have the insert and overwrite sequences as nests or individual clips option. This option allows you to control how sequences are inserted or overwritten when working with nested sequences. Nested sequences are a powerful organizational tool in video editing. They allow you to take a sequence and treat it as a single clip within another sequence. This can be incredibly useful when you want to apply effects, transitions, or adjustments to multiple clips as a group, or when you need to create complex compositions and maintain a structured timeline. For example, if you have a sequence named as Sequence A within your project and you want to insert or overwrite it into another sequence named as Sequence B, you can choose between two options. 1. Insert and overwrite as individual clips. If you select this option, Premiere Pro will treat the contents of Sequence A as individual clips. When you insert or overwrite Sequence A into Sequence B, each clip within Sequence A will be placed on its own track in Sequence B. This level of control lets you fine-tune the clips and their arrangement in the new sequence like a pro. 2. Insert and overwrite as nest. If you choose this option, Premiere Pro will treat Sequence A as a single nested sequence. When you insert or overwrite Sequence A into Sequence B, the entire contents of Sequence A will be treated as a single clip and placed on a single track in Sequence B. It's perfect for keeping things grouped together and preserving the overall structure of Sequence A within Sequence B. Now we have a Snap and Timeline button. Shortcut for Snap and Timeline is S. It allows us to magnetically snap one edit to the end of another. For example, if it is off, whenever we drag clips on the timeline, there's a possibility that the clips will not attach to each other. There will be gaps in between clips. Turning the Snap and Timeline will make sure there are no gaps while dragging and dropping the clips on the timeline. The next one is the Linked Selection button. The Linked Selection button allows you to toggle the connection between the video and audio on the timeline. For example, if I select this clip on the timeline, the audio will be selected too. Once I turn off the Linked Selection, I can work separately with audio and video. Then we have a marker icon, which adds markers on the timeline wherever the playhead is placed. Markers can be used for commenting about selected parts of the timeline, defining chapters in the project, and for adding a URL that provides more information about selected parts. For example, place your playhead where you want to add markers on the timeline. Make sure clips are not selected and select marker icon, or simply use the M shortcut and a marker will be added to your timeline. Now double-click the marker to change its name, duration, comments, chapter marker, web link, etc. Beside the marker, there's an icon for settings of timeline. Under Timeline Settings, the first one is Show Source Clip Name and Label, which shows the names and labels of your clips if you have given them. Show Video Thumbnails. It provides a reference frame on each individual clip. Show Video Keyframes. It will display keyframe information straight on our video clips if you have a keyframe on video. Show Video Names. It will display the names of the videos. Show Audio Waveform. It will show waveforms for the audio used on the timeline. Show Audio Keyframes. It will display audio keyframes if you have them. Show Audio Name. It will show the names of the audio on the timeline. Show Clip Markers. It will show markers if you have marked any on the timeline. Show Duplicate Frame Markers. It will help us if any clips or frames are displayed more than once on the timeline. Show through edits. It shows a cut in a clip where there is no change on either side of the clip. Show FX badges. It has three types of badges. The first one is a gray one, which means there's no change with your clip. The second one is yellow, which means you have keyframes on your clips. And the third one is green, which means you have an actual effect on your clip. Show proxy badges. When you're using proxies in your existing project, you'll see a specific icon displayed on the top left of your video clips. Adobe Premiere Pro uses proxies, which are smaller, lower resolution versions of your original video files. These proxies help make the editing process smoother and more efficient, particularly when dealing with high-resolution footage like 4K or higher formats. Composite preview during trim. It simply shows you a composite of both the frame being trimmed and the frame of the current clip on the timeline. You can turn this off to see a full-screen preview of only the frame being trimmed. Minimize all tracks. It will minimize all the tracks on the timeline. Expand all tracks. It will expand all the tracks on the timeline. Save presets. This will create a preset from your current timeline settings. Manage presets. Here you can manage your timeline presets. Customize video header. It helps us to customize video headers available on the timeline. Customize audio header. It helps us to customize audio headers available on the timeline. At last, we have Close CC, which is for captions. This one allows us to toggle between showing and hiding captions on the timeline. Now, to remove the green screen from your footage, click the video on the right. And to put this video inside the text, click the video on the left. To master the art of video editing, graphic design, and animation, subscribe to Novella Film Academy. And that's it.